This is how you can create rich 3D scenes to your stories. Here we see a completely empty project containing only a title. The first thing I'll do is to add a second section so we can scroll through the story. Then we'll jump straight into it and open the background elements panel. Click on the Add New Element button and choose the 3D scene module. When we do that, we can see a new edit mode tailored to working in a three-dimensional space. Right now, we're seeing the default scene that contains these four elements. We have a 3D model of a bust in the middle here, along with some lights. To toggle the properties of a 3D element, we can either click on the object, or we can click in the element list to the left. Different elements have different properties. If we open a point light, we can see that we have a setting controlling the color of the light. By changing the color, we create new lighting conditions for the bust. We can save our work in Scene Creator by adding snapshots. So when we're happy with how the scene looks, we can click Add Snapshot. And if we now go back by clicking the X in the corner, we can see that we have a timeline for the 3D element. First, we'll quickly edit the opacity so the scene becomes visible. Now, the real power comes from creating multiple snapshots. We can open the Scene Creator again by clicking on the colorful part of the timeline. We'll now make some changes to the scene and then save those changes as another snapshot. We'll edit the intensity of the lights and add some rotation to the 3D model. To add the modified view as a new snapshot, click Add Snapshot, and now we have two. Clicking on the snapshots will animate between them. We now have two snapshots, and when we go back to the overview, we can see that we also have two keyframes, one for each snapshot. By dragging the keyframes, you can adjust when in the story the different keyframes are active. Now, when we scroll down, you can see that the scene animates between the two snapshots that we created. Using two or more snapshots, we can really add interesting elements to our storytelling. To explore how we can make it more interesting, let's go back into the Scene Creator and look at some of the other options that we have. Every snapshot can be made interactive for the reader of your story. To add interactivity, you can hover on a snapshot, click the cog icon, and that will open additional snapshot settings. Here we have the option to edit the name, but we'll turn on this toggle under interactive. When you go back, you're now able to click and drag and choose the perspective you want to see of the model. The readers of your story will also be able to interact with the model, and indeed, if we click outside and try to click and drag on the story, you can see that it's interactive here as well. Another form of interactivity are pointer-controlled camera movements. To enable those, we can go into the snapshot settings, we'll disable the interactive toggle, and ramp up the settings for pointer-controlled movements, both the left and right, and up and down. When we now move the mouse pointer, we can see that the perspective changes a little bit as we move. We can make the effect more prominent by setting higher values for both left and right and up and down movement. So far, we have looked at changing a single element between snapshots. But if we want to move all the elements in parallel, there is a way to do that as well. First of all, we need to start by removing all the keyframes. We need to add a couple of more elements, so we'll start by adding some basic shapes. First, we'll add a sphere and place it a little bit to the left, and for effect, we'll make it more metallic looking. We'll adjust the scale a bit, and then we'll go on to create another shape. We'll add a box this time, edit the metalness and the roughness, change the rotation a bit, and place it to the bottom right. And finally, we'll add one more element. We'll use the geometry torus. We'll adjust the radius and tube a bit, place it to the top right, adjust the rotation, and make it more metallic. Let us now save this configuration as our first snapshot. Now, if we rotate the bust a bit and create a new snapshot, we see that only the bust moves. Many times, this is completely fine, but if we want to change the perspective for all the elements at the same time, we can unlock the camera by clicking here. When a camera is unlocked, you can click and drag to rotate the entire scene. You can scroll to zoom in or out, And when you have a view that you're happy with, you can save that as a new snapshot or override an existing one by hovering over the snapshot and clicking the override icon. If we now move the camera by rotating and zooming in a bit, we can create a new snapshot, disable the free camera view, and you can now see the snapshots animate between the two camera views that we have. To make it more subtle, we'll go into both snapshot settings and reduce the pointer-controlled camera movement. And finally, there is one more type of setting in the scene creator. If you click this cog, you'll open up the scene global settings. These are settings that will be applied to the entire scene. Here you can add a background image called an HDRI. You can use one of our preloaded HDRIs by clicking on the library button here. We'll select hilly terrain, and now you can see that we have a background image for the entire scene. If we use the free camera mode, we can spin around and see that this image fills the entire scene. And in addition to that, you can see that the objects in our scene reflects the light and colors from the background HDRI. If we switch to another HDRI, you can see that we get a new background and a new lighting for the objects in our scene. If we don't want a background image, but still want to keep the rich colors and lights, we can remove the background HDRI and instead use an environment HDRI image. But for this project, we'll keep the full background image. As a final touch, we'll find a dramatic looking camera angle, override that as our first snapshot, and then we'll rotate the scene a bit, and to add to the drama, we'll change the rotation for the cube and the torus. After that, all we have to do is override the second snapshot. Now we can change back to the locked camera mode and see what the transition looks like. When we're happy, we can close the scene creator and see how the scene works with the other elements in the story. We can adjust the keyframes, and we'll toggle to the full preview mode to try out the interactivity. By default, the 3D scene fills the entire screen of your story. If you don't need that, we can change the frame options. Here we can set the width to be 50% of the screen and the alignment to be right. When we then go out, we can see that it only fills half the screen. All that is left then is to add a title and add a blend mode. And there we have it. This is how you can create rich 3D scenes in your digital storytelling. Continue learning at instorier.com/learn or on our YouTube channel. See you soon.